Raider Nation, Mitchell Renz here from the Raiders Report. If you haven't yet, make sure you subscribe and join us every single Tuesday when we go live, 6 p.m. Eastern Time, 3 p.m. Pacific. Or if there's breaking news like Jon Gruden is resigning, we're also going to be going live for that. So turn on those notifications. So I always tell people, hashtag Raiders or Super Chat. We got the first ones coming in here from Frank Ramirez. Any trades you see happening now that Jon Gruden is gone? The first trade that I would make is, honestly, Matt Hennessy. He's a center for the Atlanta Falcons. They already drafted a center as well this past year's draft. I said draft like 100 times. But Matt Hennessy in Vegas, he's a veteran. He's a good center. That would be an option. Also, some defensive tackles on the free agent market still, though. But I will be making a video around some potential trade targets. Let's go to MK1980. Offensive line first, coach next year. I'm kind of with you on the idea that they have to do something with the O-line. If you want to be, you want to make a big splash, Bisaccia, you want to please a lot of people early on, switch up the offensive line. You're going to be a very big-time fan favorite. Let's go to Mildish Nidorino, which I believe is a Pokemon. Raider skulls for the new Chucky heads. With Chucky gone, DC will have more influence in the play calling, and we'll get to see what he's really about. I do think Carr will have more to say, and I think him and Greg Olsen are going to work really, really hard together. But Raider Skulls is definitely also going to be in consideration. But like I've said before, I like just win babies. Let's go to Rudy 54-53. I think there are many reasons this is a very attractive head coaching gig. Carr is among them. I do think that this is a very attractive coaching gig. However, I don't really think that Carr is one of the reasons, because you're going to see a new head coach if he comes in. I would be very shocked if he doesn't go out and try to get his own personal quarterback. Carr is a good quarterback, and I'm not trying to take that away from him. The only way that you're going to keep him is if he takes an extension, and it's going to be a cheap deal. If Derek wants to get money, and I believe that he's probably going to get over $30 million a year, but maybe he takes a team-friendly deal because he wants to remain a Raider. It's just there's a lot of unknowns there. Let's go to Anthony. I'd hire a young, fiery head coach and offensive coordinator, Bieniemy. Here's the issue. Eric Bieniemy is not going to come to the Raiders to be an OC. He would stay with the Chiefs. The only way you're getting Bieniemy is if you hire him to be a head coach. But I want somebody young, I want somebody new, and I want something creative. That's what I want. What do you guys think here? Would you want the Raiders to hire Eric Bieniemy? I want you to go ahead and type H for hire, or I want you to go ahead and type P for pass. Bieniemy was on my list of potential Jon Gruden replacements. If you haven't seen it, you know I'm going to tell you. Go ahead and hit that big red button that says subscribe. But let me know, H for hire, or I want you to type P for pass. Let's go to Dolmite X. Some advice, Mitch. Start looking for another job. NFL is headed for bankruptcy, and I don't see an ALD anywhere to save it or create a new league. Fortunately, I'm not going to look for another job, and I don't think the NFL is going anywhere because they have a lot of money. Let's go to Brian Kulig. Appreciate the 50, Brian. And I saw your DM on Instagram. I saw that you made an IG account for me, and I appreciate it. I have so many to get to. Hey, Mitch, hit you up on Instagram. Raiders will be okay. I know, man. You're one of my most loyal watchers, and I saw it. Let's go to GotNYSD. Also, what is going on with Drake's usage? Wasteful. See, I don't want to say I told y'all so, but one of the reasons why I didn't like the Kenyon Drake move, and one of the reasons why before the season started I put it as one of the worst contracts that the Raiders have, is because I saw this coming. The Raiders wanted to get Josh Jacobs working, and there was no way that you could explain to me why paying Kenyon Drake the amount of money they were made any sense when he's the RB2, and now he's barely getting any work whatsoever. So I don't have an answer for you, but I'm going to sit here and say, kind of told you so. Let's go to Ronan Speck, $50 super. Wow, that's what's up. Let's make no mistake, Gruden was a scapegoat. 600,000, it's actually 650,000 emails over a decade time period, and the only thing that came out of Washington football scandal was John's emails. Like Dave Chappelle once said, the real, and I don't really know exactly what the rest of that is, unfortunately, because the graphic cuts it off. But I 100% agree that Jon Gruden was some sort of a scapegoat. That does not mean, though, that he should not have been fired. The real show is behind the curtain. So that's the end of what Ronan had to say. But I agree with you, but I also think that John still had to go. And if I'm being honest, y'all, it saves us a lot of money and gets us out of a very bad contract with Gruden. Now, if you guys want more videos, turn on those notifications. How do you do it? Right underneath the vid, there is literally a bell. You click that bell and then click all, allow all. That way, every single time I drop a video, it pops up on your phone like a text message, like a booty call, or like a DM like I just got from Jason Salib on Instagram. And it works all the same. How do you turn on your noties? Go to your settings app, scroll down and tap YouTube, tap notifications, turn on allow notifications. And I said last week, I'm going to give some love to the people who I know got those noties on, and they try very hard to be that very first comment on a video, because believe it or not, when you comment first on a video, it helps me out. So I'm going to give you guys some love. Untouchable Raider 1960, Eli Gossman, KC Games YT, Jamie Alvarado Sr., and then Joey Bowers. My last five videos that I put out on the channel, those were the very first people to comment. You want to be on a future show? Be the first to comment. Let's go to Marcus Pratt. What up, my man? Any investigation into Dan Snyder and the Washington football team misconduct only turns up dirt on some real, on someone not in the organization. Gruden is guilty, but this is shady. Agreed, and I agree. The more and more I read into this, the more and more I'm starting to think that Raj Goodell's got something to hide. Let's go to Rudy, 54-53. Probably should have resigned sooner. Those sentiments go against everything Al stood for. You're right. This is everything Al went against. And some people are like, oh, it happened 10 years ago. I don't care if it happened 10 years ago. Some of it happened in 2018. It's 100% everything Al went against, and I really believe if Al would have known that those emails were out there, he never would have wanted Jon Gruden to be the head coach of the Raiders. And I think his son, Mark, 100% agreed with that. So I'm with you, Rudy. Let's go to Shane. My top three 2022 coaching candidates, Bill Musgrave, Eric Bieniemy, Byron Leftwich. Thoughts? All three of those names are on my Jon Gruden replacements video. However, one of them is listed as, God, I hope this never happens. I'll let you figure out who is who. Again, y'all, use hashtag Raiders, or you can go ahead and super chat to get your questions on the show. Please let me know. So don't go to that. Appreciate the super Dolmite. But again, like I said, if you're going to put random stuff, I'm not going to put it up on screen. Let's go to 805 Hunter. Antonio Brown called Mayock a cracker and Tyreek Hill beat a pregnant woman and broke a kid's arm, yet they still playing. I will say there is a double standard to certain things, which I agree. I do not 100% understand. But again, it's the NFL. They were after Jon Gruden at the end of the day. Let's go to Richard Hogan. Appreciate the $5 super chat. Change Chucky heads to bowl cuts. I'm not going to do that because I don't want to rip on Mark. And I also would rather do something that's in a positive light, simply because, again, I don't really think that's what Al would want, is for me to rip on his son. But you're not the first person to say bowl cuts. But if we're going to do anything Davis related, it's going to be around Al, not Mark. Let's go to Armando. I hope the team rallies up and starts playing better. We can still get through this. Let's get this win on Sunday. Hashtag beat the donkeys. Hell yeah, man. I just want to take care of business. I want to see a good game, and I want to see a motivated team. And I'm hoping we get to see all of that this upcoming week up against the Broncos. Now, if you want to bet on the Raiders to beat the donkeys, what I want you to do is go to chatsports.com/Raiders, promo code Raiders125. It's going to get you 125% deposit bonus. The last time that I checked, the Raiders were 3-point underdogs. Now, I get it. This one's in Denver. But the Raiders have won 4 out of the last 5 matchups up against the Broncos. And if you're like, okay, I want to take those odds, chatsports.com/Raiders. Again, promo code Raiders125, 125% deposit bonus. Now, what you guys are about to see are some of my bets from Week 5. And I actually did pretty good. I went 4-1 for my Week 5 bets, though. The bets that I input for Chat Sports were different, and I kind of lost that, which kind of sucks. But that's besides the point. I did go 4-1, which is pretty solid. My Week 6 bets this week, I got the Chiefs -6.5 up against the football team, and I'm taking a lot of unders. That Miami-Jacksonville game, under 45.5. That one's in London. Seattle and Pittsburgh, no Russell Wilson, and Big Ben stinks. And he also doesn't have Juju, 42.5. LV up against Denver, the under is 44.5, and that one in the Bills, -5.5 at Tennessee. Now, here, if you want to make this deal a little bit sweeter at BetUS, I'm also going to be able to hook you guys up with a jersey. So not only are you going to get 125% deposit bonus, not only are we going to hook you guys up with the bets that I've made, if you go ahead and get started, and this deal is only going to be valid for this week, go to chatsports.com/Raiders, make a first-time deposit at BetUS, and then I'm going to hook you up with a free Raiders jersey. We got Josh Jacobs, Bo Jackson, and Derek Carr jerseys. If all you heard was free jerseys and you want more information on how to get the hookup, email me, jersey@chatsports.com. I'm going to say it again. First-time BetUS users, you got to use chatsports.com/Raiders. Got to use the promo code, and then I will give you a jersey out of my kindness of my heart. It has nothing to do with BetUS. Email me, jersey@chatsports.com. Let's go to Christian M. How confident are you that Mark Davis can make the right head coaching decision? How confident am I? I'm not really confident, if I'm being personally honest. I'm hoping Mark Davis watches the Raiders report and takes some of my recommendations, because from the draft, from some of the free agency stuff, from other what have yous, Mark Davis has not done a lot of the best decision-making. I think we would all agree with that. So, Mark, watch the Raiders report. Hire one of my top four guys. Let's go to Mo Dizzle. Goodell now probably has a lot of dirt on NFL VIPs. This was a demonstration of power for something that can go against him. He can destroy them by leaking. Yeah, like I said, Roger Goodell, I think, is the ultimate reason here why Jon Gruden is fired and why nobody else has lost their job yet. But we all know that Roger Goodell's a coward and he's going to hide behind certain things. I mean, there's no reason. Like, tell me any other sport where the guy gets booed the way Roger Goodell does. Why? Nobody respects him. So what do you guys think here? Okay, I like this one. What's the best burger joint in Vegas? So I don't know if you guys know this, but I'm going to be out in Las Vegas for basically every single Raiders home game, I think minus the one on December 26th, the day after Christmas, obvious reasons. But let me know some of the best burger joints in Las Vegas. I want to be able to hit up some of my favorite spots. I mean, my go-to, the one that I literally go to every single time, is Barcode Burger in Vegas. If you guys haven't, please go ahead and check it out. If you use promo code, not even promo code, just tell them Mitchell Renz sent you. They'll give you 15% off your very first order. So if you guys want to go ahead and get a hookup, they got, I think they also got awarded the best burgers in Las Vegas. But you know what? I love burgers. It's my favorite place. So please give me some other ideas of some places I can go. Let's go to Juicehead89. Thoughts on drafting Bryce Young or sign Watson? New head coaches want their own guy. Well, first off, Bryce Young, he's not eligible, and I get that he's coming off a pretty good game, but not eligible. And then Watson, like, here's the issue. How are you going to fire Jon Gruden, and then you're going to sign somebody who's got 22 allegations against women? Like, that's the problem with the NFL. Deshaun Watson is eligible to play, but he's got 22 allegations against things that he physically did to women, yet Jon Gruden gets fired for emails that he sent. I think the allegations of Deshaun Watson touching women is a lot bigger deal than the emails. Call me crazy. Let's go to Kyle Hot Hate. I don't know. We got the Raiders should go for Mitchell Schwartz and Russell Okung, also Marshall Newhouse. If I'm not mistaken, all offensive linemen are still free agents. Yes, you are correct. If I had to pick out of all those names, I would go with Mitchell Schwartz because he's the right tackle. Russell Okung is a left tackle, and he's had even more injuries than some of those other guys. I'm going to pass on Marshall Newhouse. If you want to go out and sign a guard, I still think Nick Easton's the first name I'd call, but also Forrest Lamp. That's probably that. Let's go to Nick. Hell of a picture here. Mariota to the rescue. Mariota is probably going to be playing this week up against the Denver Broncos. Now, again, I am filming this Tuesday, so we might get some different information, but the fact that Las Vegas decided to release Kyle Slaughter today also tells me that they are also pretty confident that Mariota will play this week. Let's go to Cosmic Lopeman. How about Madden heads? Nothing more legit than John Madden. Again, you're not the first person to go ahead and bring up John Madden or Madden heads in general. It's definitely an option. I just think, like, I love Madden. However, and I'm going to say however, I would rather do something related to Al Davis. But I didn't really ask you guys the first time I did it, so I'm probably going to ask you guys this time. We're going to make some sort of tournament style of what you guys want to be the new Chucky head meter. Let's go to Jose Valencia. Will this be the final year for Mayock now? And if yes, who would you hire? If I had to make a bet, I would actually probably put more of a bet down that it is going to be Mayock's final year. However, if he's gone, the very first name I call is Lewis Riddick. Lewis Riddick wants the job. He's come out and said that he's wanted the job, and I know he's a big-time Raider fan. So why not give it to somebody like that who legitimately wants it? If there's other GMs out there, I'll start doing my homework, but I think the top of the list right now is Lewis Riddick. All right, y'all, what do you think? Will this be the final year for Mike Mayock? One for yes, or want you to go ahead and type two for no. Let me know down in the comments section. Curious what you guys have to say. If I was a betting man, probably go ahead and say one for yes, though. I don't know if it would be 100% fair for Mac. I kind of want to give him one more chance without Jon Gruden. Let's go to Sam Russo. Sad to see Gruden go, but regardless of what he said, I don't think he was ever going to bring a Super Bowl to Las Vegas anyways. Outdated. And here's the issue. I agree with this statement, and it kills me to say it because so long I talked about Gruden, you hoped that he could get it together, but he was 100% outdated. And you're 4 years into the process, and he still was trying to find his own identity. He literally said it a few days ago. So I'm kind of with you on this, and it gets you out of $60 million, 6 years guaranteed. And hopefully never again you give somebody that much money and that much guaranteed time. Let's go to Alfredo. Eagles-Raiders game, you'll be there. I won't actually be at the stadium. I am going to be, though, in Las Vegas, and I'm going to be doing a watch party. The location of the watch party is still TBA, as this time, though I'm 95% sure of where I'm going to be. I'm just not allowed to release exactly where that is. But if anybody wants to hang out with me in Las Vegas during that weekend, hey, hit me up on Instagram, MitchellRenz365. Let's go to No Ortiz. What do you think about Greg Roman for head coach? Well, no. Go check out my Jon Gruden replacements video because you will see Greg Roman on that list. I'm not going to tell you where exactly where he is, but obviously if he's on my list, it means I like him. Let's go to Vincent Thrower. How do you throw a Vincent? What's up with Morrow and White at linebacker? Still no update on how healthy both of these guys are. Now, they were eligible to come off IR. The issue is you basically have a three-week time window, right? So when players come off the IR, the short-term IR, which is what the new NFL rule is, you basically have 3 weeks to be able to determine, okay, are they going to go back on the long-term IR? If they do, that means their season's over. Now, I anticipate both Morrow and White to be back soon. However, I don't have the exact date, and I don't know if they're going to play this week. I'm hoping that they end up playing, though, next week. Now, again, guys, we got a lot of questions on today's show. We've had over, 1,700 people watching. If you guys haven't already, please hit me up on Instagram. I will get to your questions. Just please realize that I have a lot of DMs to get to. It's just going to take me a little bit of time. I probably won't be able to get through all of them until end of the week, but every single morning before I go to the gym, I get up at 5, I take out my dog Chuck. Then, guess what? I go through all the DMs. So I promise you, I will get to them. Just hit me up on Instagram, MitchellRenz365.